Welcome after the break, and this is another session. We lost the video in the last video lecture, and this is a sort of separate video. It can be considered like lecture number 9. In last video, we have discussed about that how y is equal to mx plus c will be tangent to a parabola y square is equal to 4ax. Y square is equal to 4x. So the condition we have derived, that is called condition of tangency. Tangency. Condition of tangency. A line y is equal to mx plus c will be tangent to the parabola y square equal to 4x if c is equal to a by a, right? So this is a condition, that is a line of the form y is equal to mx plus a by m will be always tangent to the parabola y square is equal to 4ax, right? Will be always tangent to the parabola y square is equal to 4x. This is what one thing you need to remember. And if you think, and you may ask, if the line is parabola is not y square is equal to 4x but x square is equal to 4ay, then what will happen? Similar like condition you can derive, right? A line y is equal to mx plus c will be tangent to the parabola x square is equal to 4ay if c is equal to minus am square. C is equal to minus am square. That can be also derived simultaneously. That just for sake of convenience, I can derive this. But you need to remember that is, you can say y is equal to mx minus am square is a line always touches the parabola x square is equal to 4ay. X square is equal to 4ay. So these two points you must remember, and it will be very, very useful for solving other questions. Even for objective questions, you will be able to solve it by this help very quickly. And also, any questions, it will give a bright concept, a good concept in which you will be able to derive the other mathematical calculations easily. So, two things, that c is equal to a by m and c is equal to minus am square. And how this will come, let me explain this in few seconds as well. That how this will happen, y c is equal to minus m square, even you can do that also, but let me explain, in few minutes it will take. Y is equal to mx plus c and x square is equal to 4ay. So solving these two, on solving we get this, on solving we can find it, what find it? That x square is equal to 4a and y is equal to mx plus c. So what will happen? This will be x square is equal to 4amx plus 4ac, or we can say x square minus 4amx minus 4ac is equal to 0. Now for equal roots, again the same logic, equal roots, d must be equal to 0. And therefore, 4a minus 4am whole square is equal to 4ac. A is 1 and c is minus 4ac. So this will be 16a square m square is equal to minus 16ac. A cancel, 16, 16 cancel. So AM square is equal to minus C or C is equal to minus AM square. This is what condition we have derived. So I hope you got this point, right? And you will be able to understand this, that why this will come C is equal to minus AM square and C is equal to A by M. When and how it comes, you understand it. And when it can be applied, depending upon the type of parabola. Now, the other thing is that we want to find equation of parabola at any point, a specific point. So, equation of parabola at a point P x1 y1 on y square is equal to 4ax is yy1 is equal to 2ax plus x1. This is the equation of parabola. To derive this anywhere, whether it is any type of parabola or circle or ellipse or hyperbola, anywhere, if you want to find the equation of tangent at any point x1, y1, you need to replace x square by xx1, y square by yy1, 2x by x plus x1, 2y by y plus y1, you know. And if anywhere 2xy, then replace by xy1 plus x1y. So this is what the theory in which you can find the equation of tangent at any point x1, y1. If it is an ellipse or circle or parabola or hyperbola or whatever, you know, any type of equation is there, to find the equation of tangent at that point, you can derive it easily. So here, if this is a parabola and this is a line touching the curve at this point x1, y1, this is a point P, then that will be, this is the equation, y is equal to this. But one thing clear, how you can find this, this is the equation of the line which will satisfy this and how this will happen. So when anyone can deal with this equation of tangent at point x1, y1, because this is a common point on parabola, y square is equal to 4x, so that will also satisfy the equation of parabola, and since line passes through it, so that will also satisfy the line. So this is a point we can analyze and we can develop this. On the basis of this, we can find this. And here, what will be the tangent? Any line perpendicular to tangent is called normal, right? This line is called normal. So what will be the slope of this tangent? Slope of this tangent, because line can be written as my 2a upon y1 x, right, plus x1 by y1. So this is just simple comparing with y is equal to, on comparing it at y is equal to mx plus c, m is, what is that, m is 2a upon y1. So slope of, this is what, nothing else but slope of tangent. Slope of tangent is this. Now say this is the slope of tangent, that is m1. Slope of normal is m2. Then m1, m2 must be equal to minus 1, because tangent is perpendicular to normal and normal is perpendicular to tangent at the point of contact. So this is the point of contact, this is called point of contact, right? So normal is always perpendicular to the tangent and this is the point of contact. So we are going to find it, the equation of normal. This is the equation of tangent, y is equal to 2a upon y1, x plus x1 by y1. And now, we want to find the equation of what? Normal. So, giving this relation, m1, m2 is equal to minus 1, m2 is equal to what? Minus 1 by m1, and that is minus y1 by 2a. because m1 is this. Equation of normal now you have to find. So therefore, equation of normal at point x1, y1 to the parabola y square is equal to 4x is given by what? y minus y1 is equal to slope minus y1 by 2a x minus x1 using one point form, and that will come 2a y minus y1 plus y1 into x minus x1 is equal to 0. And this is the equation of normal to the parabola. Right? So we can conclude this equation of normal to the parabola edge this, and equation of tangent edge this. So remember this equation of tangent, to find equation of tangent at any form of parabola, whether it is y square is equal to 4a or x square is equal to 4ay, replace x square by xx1, y square by yy1, and 2x by x plus x1, and 2y by y plus y1, and if there is any here 2xy, replace by this xy1 plus x1y. So I hope you got this. This is the equation of tangent and equation of normal. These two formula in the box what have been written, you must remember it, and it will be very very useful, and there are several applications of this formula, you can find it. Now, point of intersection of this tangent to the axis of parabola and point of intersection of normal to the parabola can be determined as well. And also, we can learn about the length of tangent to the parabola and length of normal to the parabola. So, what will be that? Let me write here. This is a tangent, right? And this is the normal. So, tangent and normal. If this is a parabola, say, and this is the axis of parabola, this is a point P where x1, y1 is the coordinate, and this is the equation of tangent. No? So, this is the equation of tangent. So, PT is a tangent. Normal at this point is like this, and which will come to this point at N. N is the point where it lies. So, this is normal, and this is the origin. Say, origin O. And here, if I draw a perpendicular from this point of contact, that is M. So, MN is normal is PN, normal is PN. This is also perpendicular to the tangent, and N is PN is perpendicular to this normal. T is a point of contact where it met at x axis, that is axis of parabola, and P is the point at which tangent is drawn. Now, equation of tangent is this. This is the equation of tangent, and I want to find the point of intersection on what axis of parabola. This is x-axis, so of course y is equal to 0. So to find the point of intersection, that is coordinate of t, we can put y is equal to 0. So put y is equal to 0 to get point of intersection on axis of parabola. And if I put y is equal to 0, then what will happen? If y is equal to 0, this thing will 0, x is equal to minus x1. So x plus x1 is equal to 0, that is x is equal to minus x1. This implies x is equal to minus x1 and y is equal to 0. So this point has coordinate minus x1 comma 0. This point has coordinate minus x1 comma 0. To find the equation of normal, again, to find point of intersection to find point of intersection of normal to the axis of parabola we can put again y is equal to 0 which is also on x-axis. So y is equal to 0 will make it what? Minus 2a y1, because 0 minus y1 is minus y1, plus y1 into x minus x1 is equal to 0. That will give y1 x minus x1 is equal to my 2a y1. Y1 cancel because it is a non-zero constant, and therefore x minus x1 is equal to 2a, and therefore x can be written as x1 plus 2a. X1 plus 2a is the point of intersection, and so point of intersection here will come x1 plus 2a comma 0. Now we have to find the length of tangent and length of normal. So this point is, what will be the coordinate of this point? This M, if I would draw perpendicular to this, this will be x1 comma 0. X1 comma 0. This length is x1. This length is minus x1. So total length is 2x1. And this length would be x1 plus 2a minus x1. That length must be equal to 2a. So this point is called subnormal. Length of tangent. If I would find length of tangent, then what will happen? Let me write this. Length of tangent to the parabola. You understand this point of intersection? Now I have to write this. Length of tangent to the parabola. Tangent PT is equal to given by x1 plus x1 whole square plus y1 square, that is 2 times of 2x1 whole square, that is 4x1 square plus y1 square, that we can discuss. Length of normal, that is Pn. And what is that Pn is? X1 plus 2a minus x1 whole square, x1 plus 2a minus x1 whole square, and plus 0 minus y1 whole square. So that will come up here also. X1 cancel. This is 4a square plus y1 square. Length of subtangent. Subtangent is what? Right? Subtangent is m to n is called subnormal. I am going to rub this. I am writing here just. This is now length of, I can write here, length of subtangent. Subtangent is what? Length of subtangent is mn, mt. And what is this distance? 2x1. X1 plus x1, that is 2x1. And length of subnormal. Subnormal is what? The distance from point of intersection of normal to the axis of parabola from the foot of perpendicular at the point of intersection, point of contact. So MN is subnormal. MN is considered as subnormal. And what is this length? H 2a. So length of subtangent, length of subnormal, length of tangent, length of normal, all that can be determined by using this concept. And how to develop this, you understand it well, and now you will be able to analyze whenever or wherever it is given. Suppose someone wants to find the area of this triangle P, N and T. What will be the area of triangle formed by the normal tangent at any point x1, y1 to the parabola y square is equal to 4x with x axis? So in that case, area of triangle PTN or PPN is equal to half into base into height. What is that base? This is a base here. This is the base and this is height. So PT into PN. PT into PN. That will be the length into breadth. Or you can find the area of this triangle PT into PN. PT into PN. If I would multiply this, what will come here? It will come like 1 by 2. And this square root will be inside. It is 4x1 plus y1 square, 4x1 square plus y1 square into 4a square plus y1 square, and that will be the area of triangle. Depending upon the value of x1, y1, if one should can realize or memorize this statement, then understood this, x1, y1 must be given in the parabola, a must be given in the parabola. So one can put the value of x1, y1 and a directly here, and they can find the area of the triangle made by the tangent and normal at any point P on parabola with its axis of the parabola. So different dimensions can be achieved with the single equation, single diagram. And some more useful dimensions can be also done by using this fact. So let me discuss something new. I hope you got it. Right now? I hope you got it. Should I run this? Okay. Now let me discuss about the parametric equation of parabola. Parametric equation. Parametric equation of parabola. Parabola. Parametric equation of parabola. What is this parametric equation? Try to understand this. If y square is equal to 4ax is any equation of parabola, parabola, then we need to find the parametric equation of this. Parametric is something which para means different, metric means measurement. In different way of measurement, that will be suited and satisfy the equation. So here for this way, the parametric equation is x is equal to 80 square and y is equal to 280 will satisfy this. If I put x is equal to 80 square, RHS will be 4a square t square. And if I put y is equal to 280, the whole square will make it 4a square t square. So therefore, parametric equation of this parabola is this. This is a point which will satisfy the equation. So it is called parametric equation of parabola. Parametric equation on parabola. Equation of parabola. Right? So this is a parametric equation of parabola. I hope you got it. Okay? Parametric equation. So any point T on parabola, any point T on parabola, parabola y square is equal to 4x, it means the point is, the coordinate of the point is, coordinate of the point is, what coordinate of point is, 80 square comma 280, right? So if we will refer any point t on parabola y square is equal to 4x, means point is t. If similarly, if we say if T1 and T2 are two points on parabola, are two points on parabola, on parabola, y square is equal to 4x, it means points are, what? Points are a t1 square comma 2a t1 and 82 square comma 282. This is what the points. In place of T1 and T2, A will remain same, T1, T2 will vary it. And that will give the two different points on parabola which will satisfy the equation. So parametric equation of parabola, if T be any point, then T1 square 2A T1, this is a point. Instead of x1, y1, I have transferred in this form of T, and T is called parameter. Here A is constant, x, T is a parameter, parametric equation, where T is called parameter. T is called parameter, and parameter can change. So here T1, T2 can change, T is just variable called parameter. Right? So any point T on parabola means this. Any point T2 on parabola means point is AT2 square comma 2AT2. So points are described like this, and we will learn tangent and normal on this point as well. And most of the question will be solved by using in parametric form. We will use parameter T at any point on the parabola, and it will make our calculation convenient. Instead of x1, y1, we will use T as a parameter and parametric point, because most of the properties of parabola is given in terms of T only, right? So we learn new things, parametric equation, and parametric equation similar like what we have discussed in circle and what we have discussed in other part of conic can be also discussed. Parametric equation, this is a parametric equation of this type of parabola. If parabola is x square is equal to 2ay, then what will happen? Suppose if x square is equal to 4ay is the equation of equation, then what will be the parametric equation? X square is equal to 4ay. In that case, in place of y, it will be at square, and in place of x, this will be 280. At square and x is 280. So in that case, this is a parametric equation. Parametric equation of parabola. Parabola. X square is equal to 4ay. Because this will satisfy. So if I am saying any point T on parabola x square is equal to 4ay, that is point would be, what point would be? Point would be and 280 comma 80 square. So this is the change. X coordinate and y coordinate will interchange if the parabola will interchange. That is, the axis of parabola will interchange, then x coordinate and y coordinate will interchange simultaneously. And I hope you got this. So similarly, if t1, t2 are two points on parabola, x square is equal to 4ay, we can write 2at1, at1 square, 2at2, at2 square are two different points on the parabola. And we will use the tangent and normal on this parabola in next class. So till then, you revise all these things, and you must be aware about the fact of what we have discussed in this video. And I hope you will memorize this, revise this, and keep watching our video. Thank you very much. Thanks a lot. God bless you.